Hello friends, in this tutorial video I will show you how I edit my audio transcript to achieve higher accuracy using otter.ai. I am going to use an example audio transcript from Transcribe exam. Watch carefully this video till the end and this will help you in the exam. So let's start the video. I click on transcribe to audio that I transcribe using otter.ai automatic transcription software, and then I click on edit and I start editing this video.
What do we know about globalization? I think even now we're still adjusting. We're still adjusting our stories. In fact, I've actually been changing my own story about globalization a little bit in the last few months because I've been noticing some stuff that I was not paying sufficient attention to, and I really should have. I really should have, because it's up my line very much. So this is the part where I get to tell you what I did on my summer vacation. I actually was holidaying in Scotland just relatively recently, and this is kind of depressing.
What we promised to our vacation to go to depressing. What we promised to our vacation.
Go to depressing. What do economists do on vacation? They go to museums that are focused on economics. in Dundee, economics. In Dundee, Scotland, if there are any people economics oriented who find themselves there, visit the Verdant Works Museum, which is dedicated to the history of the Dundee jute industry. And if you haven't been there, you might think of Dundee as with the name, it sounds like it ought to be some cute little town. They're trying to rebuild, but it's a grim decay. But it's a grim, decayed industrial city trying to claw its way back. And what it was industrially was it was the center of the world jute trade, which was an enormous long distance trade in the late 19th century. Taking the fibers, which come from India, treating them, drawing them, eventually ending up as burlap bags and such like. Huge business, Jutopolis. business. Judopolis is what they called it. Dundee had more millionaires per capita than any place else in Britain. How do we think about that? Part of it is that it was comparative advantage. Which is the grand theory of international trade that's dominated most of our thinking, which is that countries trade because they're different. They have different resources, different competences, and they trade in effect to take advantage of those differences. Obviously, Britain had to import the jute because it won't grow in Scotland for sure. Why was the manufacturing taking place in Britain? Because Britain had the capital, it had the technological skill, it had certain kinds of skilled labor in a way that India at the time did not. Later on, not. Later on, actually, the actual manufacturing moved to India because those things did spread, but initially at least it was something you would do in Britain. But that's not the whole story, because that says why you should be processing jute somewhere in Britain. Doesn't say why you would be doing it in Dundee. And there the answer is much closer to the kinds of things that I've spent a lot of time thinking about in my career. Which is the role of increasing returns. The role of things that accumulate. So, as is characteristic of these stories, there's some more or less accidental historical things that got it started. In the early stages, the process of treating the fibers relied on whale oil. Later it turned to mineral oil, but initially it was whale oil, and Dundee was a whaling port. And also was similar in some respects to dealing with flax, which is something they had, but all that's just how it started. It became irrelevant. You eventually had this clustering clustering. You had this process where it fed on itself. And in the economic geography, a lot of us, some years back, we discovered the works of the great Victorian economist Alfred Marshall, who focused a lot on these industrial clusters, which were very much a story of the time. There were really three things. There was the creation of a thick market for particularly highly skilled but specialized skilled labor. There were specialized suppliers of equipment, services that you needed in industry. And there was what we would now call technological spillover, but as his phrase was, the mysteries of the trade become no mystery. Mysteries of the trade become no mystery, but are, as it were, in the air. Basically, everybody in Dundee knew all about jute, and so you had this kind of clustering.
What do we know about globalization?